Microsoft, why have you forsaken us? Seriously though, what's the deal? It's the question on everyone's mind now that details regarding the Xbox One have emerged. From the moment the third generation console was unveiled, gamers everywhere have been trying to figure out why Microsoft seems so intent on shooting themselves in the proverbial foot. Before we dive into why Microsoft decided to launch the Xbox One with so many controversial features, why don't we take a look at what those features actually are? First, Microsoft recently announced their policy on used games, trade-ins, and rentals, saying, "Xbox One is designed so game publishers can enable you to give your disc-based games to your friends. But there are two requirements. You can only give them to people who have been on your friends list for at least 30 days, and each game can only be given once." This means at launch, you will not be able to rent or loan games to your friends, which, given the high ticket price of modern games, is a major complaint for financially strapped gamers. It also means that video game rental companies such as Gamefly and Redbox are wondering how they'll function once the Xbox One launches. Secondly, the feature the game community has been most vocal about is Xbox One's always online requirement. While Microsoft explained that the Xbox One didn't require constant 24-hour internet connection to work, the company did announce that the console would need to phone home once a day to Microsoft servers, which would require an internet connection. Gamers have since rallied against the feature, which singles out anyone who cannot afford internet service or active duty soldiers stationed overseas. Since the announcement of these features, Microsoft has suffered a crippling round of bad press, including one incident where Microsoft employees were caught posting positive Xbox One comments anonymously on Reddit. That's awkward. Although Microsoft claims that connecting to the internet once every 24 hours allows developers to create constantly evolving worlds even when you are not online, another theory suggests that it all comes down to a matter of piracy. The Entertainment Software Association released statistics in 2012 that suggested that the US game industry loses up to $3.5 billion a year to pirated games. And here's where the Xbox One comes in. Simply, if the Xbox One is connecting to servers once a day, it will make it nearly impossible for hacked consoles and games to run smoothly. Already, many publishers are implementing mandatory online updates for games, which often renders torrented games useless. Additionally, Microsoft is disabling the loaning or renting of games, which again ties into limiting piracy, by forcing users to register specific games to their consoles. The common practice of passing around pirated copies of a game will be eliminated. There is one problem though, and it's sort of a big one. According to a study released last month done at the Copenhagen Business School's Department of Informatics and other universities, the Entertainment Software Association's previously mentioned $3.5 billion statistic may be grossly exaggerated. The study explains that previous ESA studies were, quote, potentially biased, partially due to the interests of the industry to reduce piracy and thus potentially overestimate the problem. Statistics gathered from the study also suggest that currently there are few objective and accurate numbers about game piracy, which of course has left many wondering if Microsoft has rolled out these unpopular features to combat a problem that isn't nearly as big as they believe it to be. Gears of War co-creator Cliff Bleszinski wrote about Microsoft's possibly premature anti-piracy policies on Twitter, saying, "I still think the future of this industry is going to be a bloodbath. It's going to get ugly with many, many shakeups." All of this has left the gaming community unhappy with Microsoft's choices, but incredibly pleased with Sony's choices for the PlayStation 4. Microsoft's controversial Xbox One features are designed to limit game piracy and support developers, which leads us to wonder, why didn't Sony implement the same restrictions? Things are looking bleak for this next generation of game consoles, but who needs Xbox One when you have paper footballs? You don't have to be online to enjoy these.